Back home, the Black Meteors took a giant step towards qualification to the next stage of the Africa Under 23 qualifiers following an emphatic 5-1 win over Togo in the first leg encounter played at the Babaya Stadium yesterday. Well, hat-trick from striker Kwabena Owusu and goals from Yakubu Nasama and Bukari Osman gave coach Ibrahim Tanko's side the win. Well, football journalist Sheikh Tofik watched the game and joins me on the line. Sheikh, a very good morning to you and thanks so much for joining me. How good was Coach Tanko's team?
Well, I think that overall in the game, the team was very phenomenal, especially in the second half. In the first half of the game, the performance of the team was not really encouraging. And I think that Coach Ibrahim Tanko identified the loopholes in the team and corrected them in the second half. And you could see that the team was impregnated with a lot of tactics in the second half, and that gave Ghana the emphatic win.
5-1, of course, big win there for the Black Meteors going into the second leg, that's on Sunday. Kwabena Owusu scored 3 of those goals. Tell me more about him.
Well, this is a chap that I personally watched for the first time. I had been monitoring his exploits in Europe, but I had not watched any of his tapes. But the performance he displayed yesterday was very phenomenal. He's quite a pacey player. He's got incredible skill, and he has a magnificent, shooting ability. So it wasn't surprising. If you saw his first goal, he picked the ball from the middle, outwitted his marker, turned down another before, killing a beautiful one into the net to give Ghana the opener.
Of course.
And his second and third goals too, they were so magnificent. So I think that he's one player we can look up to going forward. I don't think that probably will be rushing him into any of the senior national teams. But gradually he can get there. He's a phenomenal player.
Sheikh, finally, before I take leave of you, I mean, you watched that game yesterday, and of course you said you were impressed with the team's performance in the second half. You think that going into the second leg in Togo on Sunday, the team can get a good result and make it to the next stage of the qualifiers?
Well, I think that if Coach Ibrahim Tanko will go into the game with a winning mentality, perhaps Ghana can win the game again in Togo or get a draw from that particular game. After the game, I spoke to him one-on-one, and he told me that he's not underrating the Togolese. This is football. Anything can happen. Until the 90 minutes is played in Togo, he's not thinking that he has qualified. And I think that is a very good mindset for Ibrahim Tanko and his boys. So going into the game, if he goes into the game with that particular mindset and goes for a win, I'm very sure that if Ghana are unable to even win the game, a draw will be good for Ghana in Togo.
All right, Sheikh, thanks so much for your time. Really appreciate it. So that was football journalist Sheikh Tofik speaking to me yesterday. He watched the Black Meteors against Togo at the Babaya Stadium, which Ghana won by 5-1. Remember, that's the first leg. The second leg is on Sunday in Togo. And obviously, we pray that the Black Meteors will get a good result. A good result, a draw definitely will see the team through to the next stage of the qualifiers. It's been a while since Ghana played at the Olympic Games. So it's our prayer that they manage to get through to the Africa Under 23 and then be part of the 3 teams that will represent Africa at the Tokyo 2020 Olympic Games. Well, we have to do some boxing, and Azuma Nelson, Ghana's boxing legend Azuma Nelson, is backing Isaac Dugbe to bounce back after his recent defeat to Emmanuel Navarrete.
It doesn't mean that it's the end of his life, his career. All they have to do is come back and go to the drawing board and see their mistakes, and then they come back again and focus for the title again. Because I've lost before, and I went and I came back. When I lost, I came back. I like I said, I went to the drawing board. I saw the mistakes that I did, and then I went back and I became world champion. So I know he can do it.
All right, so Ghana's boxing legend with some words of encouragement to Isaac Dugbe, the Royal Storm. Well, as I noted in my intro, yesterday some matches were played in England. No English Premier League games, no FA Cup games, no UEFA Champions League, but Carabao Cup, also known as the EFL Cup. So it was quarterfinal games at the King Power Stadium. It was between Manchester City and Leicester City. At the end of the game, ended 1-1, but on penalty, City progressed to the next stage of the competition 3-1. Also, the other game between two championship teams was the Middlesbrough and Burton Albion game. Burton Albion went away and beat Middlesbrough by a goal to nil. So what it means is that yesterday, Manchester City and Burton Albion making it to the semi-finals of the competition. So City is still on course, defending the title they won last season, that's the EFL Cup. And the matches to expect today, the other quarter-final games at the Emirates Stadium. The big one, of course, will be the Arsenal, Tottenham Hotspur game, and then we'll have Chelsea. They will take on Bournemouth, all English Premier League clubs encounter. Well, on that note, we are on sports this morning. Thanks so much for your company. Join us at 2 on sports today. There will be more sports here with my colleague Nathaniel Atto. Until then, enjoy the rest of our programs and have a wonderful day.